Hi, you guys. Welcome to Audrey's Reading Area. Welcome to Audrey's Reading Area. Yes, there's a reason why I'm wearing this mask because the book that I'm going to read. But first, shout out to my grandbabies, Korea. KOREA. Sanaa. SANA apostrophe A. Sanaa. David D. AVID, the third, and then Caden, KAYDY, my grandbabies. Love you guys, love you and miss you. Okay, you guys, please click the like button. Please click the share button. Please go to YouTube and smash. Yes, I said smash. You already know. Smash that subscribe button for me, you guys. Yes. All right. So the book I'm going to read is Wade Through the Pandemic by Wade and Joshua Williams. Wade Through the Pandemic. So, talking about Wade Through, I put this on underneath because it keeps it off of my lips and my face and helps me read better. So I just put that on underneath. So this now says on the back, a book about a young boy named Wade and all the things that occurred within his life through the pandemic and how he fares through it all. This book is created to encourage safe practices and provide hope as we wade through the pandemic together. Yes. Should I leave this on? Or should I take it off? Guess I'll leave it on for now. So this book was created for about and for the pandemic. Wade through the pandemic. Since today is Tuesday, Educational Tuesday. Yes. So let's jump right into this book. I did not pre-read it. Oh, and by the way, it's illustrated by Sergio Drummond. Wade and Joshua Williams wrote the book, and Sergio Drummond made the illustrations for this book. Okay. So, we're going to jump right in and read. One day, my daddy picked me up from school. He told me that he, mommy, and I were going to hang out for a while at home. Daddy said that from now on, we can only meet people over the phone. Home in red, phone in red. I asked Daddy, why does it have to be just us? He said it is because of the coronavirus. Let's see. The coronavirus is a tiny germ that, if it gets into your body, can make you very sick. So, to do our part, if we cough or sneeze, we have to do it on our arm and quick. Achoo! In our arm, like this, to cover it up so it doesn't spread. You have to put on your mask to stay strong. Put it on to stay strong. And wash your hands often to the ABC song. He's doing his part. He's washing his hands real good. And he's wearing his mask. Mommy has a baby in her belly. Actually, it's in her abdomen, not her belly. Your food goes into your belly, but just letting you know. Mommy has a baby in her belly. My little sister is coming soon. I know she will be pretty with big eyes like the moon. I can't wait to be a big brother so I can give her lots of kisses and hugs. Also, I can't wait to show her my collection of bugs. He is ready for his little sister, huh? Ready to meet her. The days go by and it's just mommy, daddy, and me all day and night. Don't you remember those days when this pandemic hit? Oh my. I want to go outside and play with kids, but daddy says the time is not right. Just as daddy told me this, he gets a call and picks up quick. Oh no! Grandma got coronavirus and she is very, very sick. Oh wow. Papa had to take Grandma to the hospital because she could not breathe. Daddy gets upset and starts chomping his teeth. I am sad because Grandmama is my one true friend I love. Daddy gets on his knees and prays to God above, up above. Time passes and Grandma is doing better, while Mommy, Daddy, and I are still together every day, practicing my letters. Then, late one night, I heard Mommy scream loud. She said, "The baby's coming. We need to go now." Mommy and Daddy rushed me to Auntie's home. We were moving so fast, they forgot my brush and my comb. We waited and waited. It seemed like all the time passed in the world. We waited and waited. Still, no baby girl. Then the next morning, I got a call from Daddy. He showed me my sister, and she was beautiful and happy. Oh. The next day, I saw my sister for the first time. Mommy named her Celine. She is sweet, cries a lot, beautiful, and clean. I gave my baby sister a nickname of Cece and show her off to my aunties and Gigi. I helped Mommy and Daddy with her by shaking her bottles and throwing her dirty diapers in the trash. Whenever me and Daddy go outside, we still wear our mask. He's holding his nose. As time goes by, Daddy goes back to work and Mommy moves out of state and gets her own place. Me and Cece go to live with Grandma and Papa at their place. We have fun at Grandmama's house playing, reading, watching cartoons, and laughing. She is my best friend, and Mommy and Daddy come to see me every weekend. My auntie gives me what I want whenever I ask, and whenever we go out, Papa yells, "Put on a mask." Cece is getting bigger each and every day. I'm so happy to have her. I show videos of her when I'm on the phone with Uncle Jay. Life is different since the virus, but everything will be okay. When you get upset, just close your eyes. Count to 10, and you will have a better day. Or go outside for a walk with a trusted adult. And don't forget your shoes. I'm wading through this pandemic, and you can too. Wade and Celine. Daddy's little princess. Oh. See you next time. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much for being here, you guys. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yes. Audrey's reading area. Shout out to my mama, who's always here. Thanks, mom, for always being here. Shout out to everyone that shares my videos. Thank you for sharing my videos. And a special announcement, I actually have 1,000 subscribers now there at Audrey's reading area. Yes, thank you all for subscribing and supporting and telling everybody to subscribe. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much, you guys. Well, now, I will see you tomorrow, right? Live, LIVE, live at 8. And I will see you then here at Audrey's Reading Area. Don't forget to go to YouTube. Yes, go to YouTube. Smash that subscribe button there at Audrey's Reading Area. Then, yes, share. Yes, subscribe. Smash the subscribe button and share. Smash and share. All right. See you tomorrow live. LIVE, live at 8.